The process of science is really fascinating to me because it involves a lot of critical thinking, a lot of collaboration, a lot of dialogue, and that you're in a community of people that, in a way, love questions more than answers. I don't think there was a particular moment where I first became interested in science, but I definitely grew up with a lot of exposure to science and to nature. Both my parents are professors, and so we traveled a fair amount. I grew up in a very rural part of Brazil, for example, and so had a lot of interactions with wildlife, with different kinds of ecosystems and landscapes. So there was always this curiosity brewing. I think over the last 100 years, we have come to gain incredible understanding of the natural world. Yet, over those same 100 years, humans have come to completely dominate the biosphere. And it makes conservation critical for other branches of science because it draws and integrates not only biological sciences, but also social sciences and many others to help us understand what is a very complex situation. And I think it's very important for society, not just science. The Center for Biodiversity and Conservation here at the AMNH is one of the research centers of the museum. It's about 20 years old, and it is a center focused on transforming knowledge to conservation action. And so we have cycles of work that we have done in the Solomon Islands, for example, where we have done everything from research on what is the diversity there, how did it evolve, all the way to working with local communities on setting areas as protected, for example, and managed by the communities themselves. We have also worked with collaborators in British Columbia, including First Nations there, to better understand the grizzly bear population. So we're doing science and research with them, using their priorities and respecting their customs. And this has led to really important new information about grizzly bears. They've shown, based on genetic analyses of hair samples, that the population was larger than they thought and that it was moving around larger distances than they thought. And this was very useful for conservation. I think what has impressed me the most from all the work that we do at the center is the passion and the capacity and the dedication of all our partners on the ground. I have worked with professors and protected area directors in Bolivia, for example, and in Peru. I have worked with folks who are leading conservation programs in protected areas in Madagascar. I have worked with rangers in Mongolia who are trying to protect gazelles, and their dedication has been a great inspiration to us throughout, and we have learned a lot from them as well.